5 minutes to go before we start, so we thought we'd just give you a little tour of Bay Park. We're living in our adventure park right now because Chile's on total lockdown. So at least here we can be outside and be free. So here's our pod where we're living. And we built this roundhouse for the kids so that they can cook their marshmallows and stuff in the dry when it rains. So now we're using that as our campfire. And yeah, come and have a look around Bay Park. Relatively, and yeah, hopefully you'll enjoy the session. I know at least my mum and dad are watching, so hi mum and dad. And hi to Mike and Marie in Denmark. Marie's in the States. And who else is watching? Team Brave in Bristol. Hi guys. Okay, so welcome to the second edition of Brave Training, a collaboration between Team Brave and the Global Goals World Cup. These sessions we're calling our Feel Good Fit Football Fitness because we're incorporating football and games and core strength exercises for our fitness, and also talking about a different global goal each time, so that we're all doing something positive for the world. Just give you a run through in case you weren't, in case you haven't watched the first session. Each time we start with an introduction and we go do a different warm-up. You may have seen my hilariously bad Zumba warm-up on the first session. Today I'm going to be doing skipping. Then we're going to go on to a football skill. So it's ideal for complete beginners, because I'm going to go really back to basics for the first bit, just going through the technique from the real beginnings. If you're a footballer or you've played a lot before, it'll be a bit of a recap. It might be a bit slow, but it's always good to practice anyway. Then we're going to go into some fun football games. I'll do one that you can do on your own, and then one that you can also do with maybe your family that you're in lockdown with. I'm going to be doing it on my own, but if you've got family or friends that you're living with, I'll give you a game today that you can do with them. Then we're going to do a core fitness challenge to keep our cores nice and strong. In the last session, everyone did really well with that one. We did the super heroine, and today we're going to do one of Brave's challenges, which is the crazy crab challenge. So we're going to be doing that, and then we'll focus on a global goal. Today's global goal is global goal 15, which is life on land, and I'll be telling you about one of my friends' teams called Let Us Be. They did amazing things for that goal. So just a quick recap of the passing session we did the other day. So we talked about using the inside of your foot, the outside, the sole, the toes and the back heel. And those are the similar kind of things that we're going to be addressing today, because we can dribble with the inside of our foot, the outside, the sole as well. So yeah, these are just some things that we recap with the technique. The importance of keeping your arms out for balance, eyes focused on the ball, your supporting foot, being alongside the ball, and then the technique of passing. So make sure every day you're maybe given a bit of time to practice these things as well. We played football skittles the other day, which is about accuracy and weighting and technique, and a game called tunnel. And today we've got a whole new set of things. So this is our plan of action for today. We're going to go through the technique of dribbling. Outside your foot, inside your foot, and the sole. We'll go through like the general things that you need to remember when you're dribbling. So I'll go through like what you need to do by looking up with the rest of your body. We're going to do a football disco, which is exciting. So for that, you're going to need to have your favourite song ready to go. It can be anything you like, whatever you feel comfortable with. And we'll use the song to help you with your dribbling. So for example, with the chorus or different parts of the song doing different movements. Then we're going to play a game called Queen of the Ring or King of the Ring. And I'll talk to you a bit about more technique, like match related. And then we'll go on to our crazy crab challenge, which I know you can't wait for. And then we'll do a global goals focus. So let's get started. Put the plan of action here. And we're going to start with a warm up today of skipping. So you'll need a skipping rope or any rope that you can find. If you don't have a rope, you can do an imaginary one. So again, as with the Zumba, I'm not a great skipper, but it's really good for overall fitness, especially in a small space. And I know boxers use it a lot to get their whole body warmed up, so let's have a go. We've got the music going, let's go. So we're gonna, because it's a short session, I can't do a full warm-up, so I'm gonna do just about 5 minutes of warm-up. So you're gonna start with just simple, so like double foot skipping. If you're doing it imaginary, then let's go for that one. No one's watching, don't worry. Okay, so that's the basic one. You can also add a jump in between if you want to slow it down a bit. And you notice I'm just on the balls of my feet, and the jumps are quite small. You can tell you just off, see how long you can keep going. World record. Okay, and then we'll have a go at doing like more like running along with the sticker. It's a bit more challenging. The good thing about skipping is you're using your upper body as well, so you're warming up your arms as well as your legs. So let's try. We're going to try for 20 seconds of that one. See how fast you can go. Okay, hopefully you're doing better than me. Next up, we're going to try hopping. So as a footballer, it's really good to strengthen your ankle ligaments, because footballers often get injuries in the ankles, so skipping's going to make them nice and strong. Let's try the other foot. Just imagining the devastation being caused by skipping ropes in living rooms across the world right now. Ornaments flying. Okay, see if you can do 10 on one foot and then swap. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's try again. We're going for 10 and then 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yeah. 1, 2. Okay, how's that going for you? I want to see a video of my mum doing this. Okay, now we're going to try a harder one, so the backward skip. So this time you start with the rope in front of you. How's that going? Okay, now we're going to try, there's another one you can do, really hard one. So you're going to do a double skip. You should feel your heart rate's increased now and you're having to breathe more. That's a good sign that you're warmed up. So the rope's going to go around twice in one jump. Try again. Okay, I'll try and do a few in a row. It's quite tricky, that one. And the last one I'm going to show you is a crossover skip. So you're going to make this shape with the rope and go through it. 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Hopefully this is testing even the most advanced skippers out there. Okay, everyone okay? Still with me? Okay, so we're going to try, just for the last bit of our warm up, everyone all together, and we're going to do as long as you can without stopping. Ready? Okay, in 3, 2, 1, let's go. You didn't see that, you didn't see that. Okay, we're starting again. If that happens, then just keep going. Just keep jumping. Okay, I'm gonna try at least 10. 1, 2. Okay, I think that's good. We're warmed up. Hopefully you're a bit out of breath and you've got nice and warm in your arms and your legs. So now we're going to do some dribbling. So lots of people have been saying, what do I do if I don't have a football? You can use any ball. You can use a tennis ball or a little ball like this, a golf ball, if you're really advanced. So it doesn't matter. Obviously a football is probably easier and more match specific, but any ball will do. Let's have a go. So we're going to take you through to the Brave Park football pitch now. Let's go. Oh god, my notes. Ready? Just Stadium of Legends. Just let us know if the wind's affecting it, if you can't hear, just tell us. So, dribbling. We're going to focus on the inside of the foot, the outside, and the sole. So when should you use the different parts of your feet? So if you watch a football game, for example, in a small area where there's lots of defenders, it's best to use the inside of your feet, because that's really good for close control. A big surface area there, the inside, and so I can keep really good control of the ball and see how it stays close to my feet. So for example, if my lovely cameraman here is a defender, then I'm gonna dribble the ball, see how it's staying close to my feet, gives me a chance to look up, and then skill and I've won again. Okay, so that's the inside of your foot. Close control, small touches, used for tight spaces. The outside of your foot, on the contrary, is used to run into space. So you might see some amazing wingers running down the side of the pitch and they've got lots of space. Or if someone breaks through a defence and they're going to be going forwards to the goal, they'll be probably using the outside of their foot or maybe a bit of the laces. Now you might be wondering why would you use that instead of the inside? And the reason is because it doesn't break the running stride. If you think about it, when you're running, you wouldn't really run like this, hopefully, okay? Unless you're a penguin. So to run normally, you're gonna be running like that. So the most normal way to dribble the ball and run at speed is gonna be with the outside of your foot, like that. The ball's gonna go further in front of you. The contrast between inside and outside, you watch, I'm doing it in slow motion, okay? So outside, the ball's really far in front of me, so it gives me time to run and catch up. So the outside, if you see when I contact the ball, it's like that. So I'm tilting my foot inwards like that, pointing my toe, and then I push it forward like that. Okay, then we've got the sole of our foot, so the underneath part. There. Okay, this is going to be used again in small spaces, in situations where you just want to have close control, maybe a turn or to confuse the defender. You might use it for a change of pace or just to get control. So imagine I've been dribbling really fast towards you, then I might use the sole of the foot to control the ball, look up, do an amazing cross into the box, or the sole of your foot maybe to confuse the defender. Again, I'm going to confuse the cameraman here. So you or the cameraman are the defender, and I'm going to use the sole of my foot, dribble back, take the ball around and go around to the other side. Or could use it to roll the ball over. And in the coming weeks, I'll have time to teach you lots of skills like that you can bring into your dribbling. But for today, we're just going to work on the basics. So to recap, the three parts of the foot we're going to be using to dribble the ball today: inside, outside, and the sole. Okay, are you ready? Just before we go onto the pitch, my lovely diagram here. So the feet are keeping control. I'm thinking about the weighting of the touches. Then we're going to have our arms out again for balance and also to protect the ball, which you'll be needing in some of the games. This is known as shielding. Then with our heads, we're going to be looking up, eyes open, spatial awareness, looking around, which will transfer onto a football pitch when you need to look out for your teammates, for the defenders. For where's the space, for where the goal is. Okay, so remember those key factors. So with our feet, with our bodies, and with our heads looking up. Okay, I think we're ready to go on the pitch. Of course, I've set up in a nice small area because I'm imagining most people are going to be in their gardens or in their bedrooms or living rooms. Probably don't have a lot of space. You can use anything. Like if you happen to have a load of cones, obviously that's ideal. but I've tried to do what probably most people have, which is maybe plastic bottles. You could also use socks, anything, just to give yourself a kind of area to keep the ball in. If you don't have a big area, you could also challenge yourself, like, okay, I'm going to dribble around the sofa, I'm going to dribble around the table, or in the garden I'm going to dribble around the flower pot, anything. It's just to give you a bit of a target. So we're going to get our feet warmed up. Right now you should put on one of your favourite songs and just get nice and warmed up with your football. And we're going to be focusing on lots of little touches, using the both feet. If you haven't got a football, you can use a small ball. It's actually going to be a more advanced workout. So it's more tricky, more difficult. It's working on your foot-eye coordination here. And again, both feet. If you do practice with a small ball, you'll notice when you move to a bigger one, it's a lot easier. And this is just about getting confident. With Team Rave, we're all about confidence, helping people through sports and activities to feel confident in their sport and then also into the wider world. So keep learning new skills is a great way to develop confidence. Going out of your comfort zone, doing something new. Just the fact that you tuned in today is really good, trying something new. Okay, so if you come a bit closer, then you'll be able to see close up of my feet. Okay, so we're gonna go focus on the inside. So inside touches. Often with kids I'll do a challenge called the penguin taps, where they've got to imagine they're a penguin, and then you're seeing how many touches you can do with the inside of your feet. So we can do that now actually, why not? So 10 seconds, ready? And you're gonna count how many penguin taps you can do. Ready, steady, go. Okay, how many did you do? If you've got time, you can just write a little note so we can know how many you did. Hopefully more than two.
10.
10, nice, cool. Okay, so that's the inside. We've done it static, stationary, and now you can do it in your area, okay? If you want, you can imagine that these water bottles or socks are gonna be defenders. So you're gonna come up to them and go around them. Hopefully the defenders don't tackle you. Not safe looking in here. Okay, with a smaller ball, also possible. Just a bit more tricky in the longer grass. Okay, so we've done the inside of your foot. Now we're going to move on to the outside of your foot. So hopefully you remember that outside of your foot you're going to use for longer distances when you've got a lot of space and you're going to be running with the ball at a higher speed. So I'm going to now run to the goal. So I've got a lot of space and you're going to see how the ball's going to be a further distance from my body. I'm pushing it forward. And I'll just run back to you to see how it's gone further. Okay, the reason for this, I've pushed it out. That gives me a chance to run. Then the ball's already in front of me, so I can whip in an amazing cross or have a shot on goal. If I was dribbling with the inside of my feet, I don't have enough space to react and prepare to shoot. So before a cross or a shot, probably going to be with the outside of your foot and then you've got space. So let's try in the area. I know you probably have a quite small area, but still try and practice the outside touches. You might hear in the background the birds of shoulder, and that's to confuse the defenders often. So if I'm going to feint to go that way, and then I'm going to drop my shoulder that way, keeping my
centre of gravity low, so that it's easier to change direction. Again, you can use the water bottles as defenders. And in the coming weeks, I'm going to be showing you some skills, and also my friend Jackie, she's doing sessions as well, and she's going to show us some different dribbling skills. So you're going to be flying by the end of this lockdown. We're going to produce some world-class players. Okay, so the similar challenge that we did before, the penguin taps, we'll try to do with the outside. So you're going to do two, one, two. Okay, so for 10 seconds, ready? 1, 2, 3, 4. How many can you do? 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, stop. How many did you get? It's a bit harder, that one. Okay, so we've done inside, outside. Now we're going to use the sole of your foot. Okay, so there's lots of ways to use the sole. Just have an experiment in your area, using the sole in different ways. So it's rolling the ball. Also, one of the brave challenges we did was the toe taps. Remember, if you've been following us, you might remember the unicorn toe taps we did, which was the fancy one. So check out the brave Instagram page or website and you can see that one. Okay, so we're going to do a challenge moving around the area, just using the sole of your foot, which is close control and used for changing directions and to surprise the defenders. So you've got 10 seconds. We're gonna see how many touches you can get whilst moving the ball. Ready? Don't start already. 3, 2, 1, let's go. Forward, backward. While you're doing it, you can think about having your arms out for balance, making sure you're looking up. Okay, how do you get on? Hopefully you're getting a good workout with this as well. Okay, so now we're gonna go into our football disco. So what you need to do is crank up your music, anything you want. I'm using some Brazilian samba music, but you can use anything, some 90s pop, some rock, I don't know, heavy metal, opera, whatever you want. You're gonna put that music on and just get lost in the music, do some dancing with the ball, a bit like what Jackie does. And enjoy. So we'll put one song on. You can choose whichever song you want at home, or you can listen to our Brazilian samba music and challenge yourself. So when the chorus comes on, or when there's a change in pace in the song, follow that pace. Or if you know that there's a word that comes in that song a lot, then you could do a change of the part of the foot every time you hear that word. Little things like that, you can choose. Okay, let the football disco begin. We should actually do a big football disco one day when lockdown's over. A football festival. Like a normal festival, but
you've got to be moving the ball. Challenge yourself if you're a more advanced player. Why not throw in a few step overs? Okay, well done. Hope you enjoyed your disco. Now we're going to go on to another game called Queen or King of the Ring. It's really popular with kids and adults, and normally you'd have someone to play with. I don't. But I have my faithful friend, the smiley ball. Okay, so imagine, I'm going to imagine these are my friends. Here's my friends I'm going to be playing the game with. So each person is going to have their own ball, okay, and you're all going to be in your ring. And the aim of the game is to keep control of your football and kick everyone else's out. Okay? So we're going to imagine that this is you and this is your ball. This is me against you. So my aim is to keep control of my ball and kick your one out of the ring. You can either play it that you lose immediately, or you can say that you lose a life. Okay, or maybe when you go out of the ring, you need to do a challenge and then you can come back in. You can make it anything, you could do press ups, sit ups, some kind of football skill. Okay, so let's play Queen or King of the Ring. I'm obviously going to have to play on my own. Okay, so when you're playing, you're going to be looking out for your other players and you're going to be trying to kick the other balls out. So practicing your tackling as well. Okay. Okay. An important technical point here is called shielding. Remember I said in the introduction, so you're going to use your arms. You might have seen this in a football match, or if you play football you might have done it. So you're going to protect your ball. So imagine I'm playing against you right now. So I need to make sure that my body is between you and the ball so that you can't get it, because if I play like this, then you can easily tackle me. It's going to be easy for you to tackle right now. But if I put myself in between you and the ball, now there's no way you're going to get the ball off me. Try. See? No way. Okay, and that's called shielding. So you're making your body into a shield. So when you're playing this game, King or Queen of the Ring, use your shielding against your family members. This is a time. You've been in lockdown for at least a week now. This is a good time to practice a bit of shielding, a bit of shoulder barging. Have a go. So shielding the ball. There's no way that you're getting this ball off me. Referee! Okay, so I hope that's causing a lot of mayhem across homes across the world of playing King or Queen of the Ring in your home. Please send in photos or videos of that. I think it'll be really funny to watch. Okay, it's the moment you've all been waiting for, the Crazy Crab Challenge. Now some of you might have experience of this if you've been following our Brave Challenges for Kids every day. If you haven't, then I'll just give you a quick run through of how to do the Crazy Crab. So it's a core strength exercise, so you need to have your body like this. You're going to tense your abdominal muscles, your glutes, your back. It's also going to work out your triceps and your biceps and your legs, so it's a bit of a full body workout. But the difference with this Crazy Crab Challenge is you're going to try to balance the ball somewhere, maybe your belly or your pelvis, okay, and you're going to see if you can walk around like a crazy crab, okay?
You could even actually play King of the Ring as a crazy crab. New idea. Okay. And you're just going to see how long you can keep moving around as a crazy crab. Now this I would love to see, especially my mum and dad doing the crazy crab in their kitchen. Okay, so I can feel this in my triceps and my deltoids here in my shoulders. Should be a good core exercise as well if you're trying to balance the ball on your core. So keep moving around. The most important thing is to keep going, and even if it starts hurting, that's a good sign that you're doing a good workout, so you just keep trying. So if you're not feeling anything, then it's not hard enough. So if you're not feeling anything, then maybe you need to make it more difficult by doing one hand, or that is difficult, or lifting one leg, making the crazy crab challenge even crazier. Okay, so each of these core challenges you can do for as long as you want, but in this episode, because we've got a limited time, I'll do them for about 5 minutes. But ideally, you could do a bit of a core strength training session and incorporate the challenge that we're doing each time. So if you remember, the last challenge we did was the superheroine, like that, or superhero. Okay, so each time we do a session, if you've got time, you could build up. So we start with the superheroine, then we do the crazy crab. And so as the sessions go on, you're going to have a routine that you'll remember. So you'll be getting stronger and stronger, and then you'll see a progression in your fitness over the weeks. So I hope that helps. I know it's hard in lockdown to keep active and fit. Okay, so we've done our technique, we've done the games, we've done our core strength challenge. Hopefully enjoyed a good football disco and Queen of the Ring battle. So now, as part of our collaboration with the Global Goals World Cup, each time I'm going to focus on a different global goal. So there's 17 global goals, and those are highlighted on the amazing Global Goals football, which is made by Air Soccer. So you can see all the global goals here. Every time we do a Global Goals tournament, each team has to work for one of the global goals and do actions that are going to help the world through that. So Team Brave, we focus on good health and well-being. So all about mental health and using sport and activity to help people with their confidence, mental health, self-esteem, and also physical health. On the first session, we focused on a different goal, the clean water and sanitation, number 6. And today we're focusing on global goal 15. Hopefully I can find it. There you go, life on land. Okay, so each week I'll do a bit of research for you, just to bring a bit of light on some of the issues, because I know now in the news it's very dominated by coronavirus, but let's talk about some other stuff that's going on in the world still. So, goal 15 facts. Every year, more than 20 million football pitches of forest, so that's 13 million hectares, are cut down for deforestation. 20 million football pitches is a lot of forest. Sadly, the impact of that is terrible, because forests are home to more than 80% of all land animals, plants and insects. So if you imagine that many football pitches of forest being cut down, is going to mean that all those animals, plants and insects don't have their habitat anymore. As a result of this, already 1 million plant and animal species are at risk of extinction, which is awful. I know there's loads of young activists out there and the kids now at home, so why don't you challenge the kids to think of what they could do to help life on land, to help all the animals. And we'd love to hear from you kids with any ideas you've got of how to help animals and how you can make the world a better place, really, with working on some different solutions so we don't have so much deforestation. I'm also going to highlight a different team from the Global Goals World Cup. This week, this session, I'm going to focus on a team called Let Us Be, which is an amazing team from Spain. I had the pleasure of meeting them at the Global Goals World Cup in Copenhagen. They're made up of ladies that some of them were victims of domestic violence, so they're really brave, really strong, and they've been using their time not only to train in football and improve in football, because I think some of them learnt from scratch, but they've also they've been working on Global Goal 15, and so their team is called Let Us Be. And what they do is they plant flowers, plant seeds, to help to have more bees, so that the bees can pollinate, therefore more plants. And they've been going around to different schools in Spain and helping the kids to plant their seeds at home and just start the discussion of what we can all do to help with life on land. So I think they're really amazing, and the women are so, so cool, really, really, really fun and lovely. And so, yeah, just want to say a hi to the team Let Us Be, and also Natalie, my friend, who's their coach out in Spain. I know Spain's going through a really tough going lockdown right now, so hope you guys are okay, and just sending you loads of love from Chile. So yeah, check out Let Us Be and some of the Global Goals 15 facts, and think about what you could do for the global goal. I hope you have a great rest of your weekend, and yeah, keep practicing the skills. Recap what you did with the passing, and then have a go at the dribbling, and yeah, look forward to seeing you for our next session. Okay, thanks very much for tuning in, guys. Hope you enjoyed it.